parking and quite a lot of so. And it's on the increase, especially with our social economic decline, which has taken which is taking place globally as a result of COVID-19 that has struck the world in such an adverse way. So it has its negative consequences, and one of those are is the vulnerabilities presented by desperation, which the throes of which poverty has thrown me into. So because of that desperation, your traffickers out there play on those vulnerabilities. And those vulnerabilities can be presented in many, many ways. Once little from organizing, sex trafficking, forced labor, porn, which forms part of the sex trafficking label, which all goes under that. There's a myriad of ways in which victims are trafficked. Everyone, don't think that it can escape you. We are all of us. Doesn't matter, there's no respect of persons, there's no respect of ages. Yes, why are we bringing this up? It is a complex gender-based violence. It is often not associated with gender-based violence because we think of gender-based violence as just being something that happens between a boyfriend and a girlfriend. Because we look at the Domestic Violence Act, and you look at the Criminal Act, and you look at all of those things that have been legislated, and recently it was changed so that it incorporates relationships between a boy and a girl, irrespective of time, even if it is 24 hours, it's only regarded as gender-based violence. Now, not all of these things, it's crime. Crime has been broken up into various facets, and one of them being gender-based violence. And then you have human trafficking, and you have human trafficking. Human trafficking is supply and demand. It's a business. It's an order that's placed. That order must look like this, packaged in that way. And that demand must be met. That's the supply I want, and that must be met. That is what gender-based violence also is. It's directing it. It's targeting a specific race, gender-based violence. It's targeting a specific, not race, sorry, gender. So that's what it does. And in the same way, targets women from what? All boys are trafficked, so your rate is looking at 44.4% of your statistics is boys. And boys are mostly used for labor. Also sex trafficking, because especially nowadays in our family, we have LGBTQI+ community, because there's a demand for that as well. Before it was just a male, female, and it just looked because of male, female scenario. Sex, no, it isn't. It's an LGBTQI+ involved also. So there's that scenario too. So boys and men is mostly for labor. So statistics, according to the National Resource Line, our National Resource Line, which is run by A21, the overtime numbers. So statistics have come out, which was done in the 2020, so we work very closely with A21 with the resource line.
Who's driving the white series? White series? Windows is open.
White series? I'm a government. And we form part of the National Freedom Network as well. We're very global, so we have presence in Africa. We've got our ambassador in the US and as well. And the statistics 5.73%, which is labor. 2.8% domestic servitude. Do you know what is domestic servitude? Domestic servitude are the helpers in our homes. And the funding was, how can we hear? Obviously, it's especially with colonization that I said we need to hear about houseboys. Have you heard that? No. We've got houseboys. Different parts of Africa. I've heard that because I come from a global school. Those things you don't realize, and then you pray for not many people, but you're failing because of these situations of poverty. So that in those homes, they may be dressed in a uniform that you just need to be the slaves. That does happen here in South Africa. Our apartheid regime fostered that kind of thing as well. Fostered a lot of the domestic servants. There are domestic servants went into these homes, a lot of your Imo servants, and they stayed there. They raised many of those children that were there, all those, I do not want to sound racist, but you rich white that have controlled South Africa for a very, very long time. A lot of domestic servants took place. Your apartheid. Human trafficking, crimes of human trafficking. If we go back, and that was brought about just 2 months ago, a discussion on 2nd October was raised. One of the things was raised, crimes of human trafficking that took place within the apartheid era. Very, very long. So South Africa is a hotspot. It's a destination. It's a transit. And as well as a place where all three ways, all of the big ways in South Africa. And at the moment, conflict is a big, big hotspot. We have a problem with organ harvesting that's taking place. It has come to life, especially with the 9-10 babies that were supposedly baby that never gave birth. Ask the question about my babies. How do you put yourself in that? It stands to reason as a journalist. Why would you contrive something that you know is going to be out there and it's going to be found out? Mm. So that raised the question. And guess what? Human trafficking. So there's many other things that haven't been included here that our organization does know about, which relates to organ trafficking. The organ trafficking is at a very, very high level. It is estimated by next year, in 2017-18, your global health was not the value of organ sold, but it was worth about 8 trillion, with COVID that has taken place, etc. It is estimated that by next year, the worth of our global health will be about 10 trillion. That's just the value. Then, if you look at your organ harvesting from me, this is your skin. A cornea, just a cornea on the black market, $50,000. A liver, $98,000. A kidney, $62,000. Right? Now, how much does that cost now? Over the period, 12,000 organs sold. Now, the pressure of the organ maker. So, human trafficking, I'm not going into, I'll go into the last part about what human trafficking is, the warning signs and all of those kind of things that you can do. You can pick it up off my website, you can pick it up off social media, any of my platforms, that kind of thing. It's there, it's frequently asked questions, you go into that section, we do a lot of blogs, so you can get that information too. Nevertheless, with that being said, your babies, your hospitals, so often you hear of babies, mothers walk away and they say, my baby's dead. Mm-hmm. Especially with babies that have been abandoned. One of the hospitals, which I haven't mentioned, obviously because the cases are ongoing, it's a known hospital, other than the ones that were spoken about with the 9 babies. There was a bust. What was happening is between social workers, and unsuccessful. They were not supposed to by law, even if the baby is abandoned, even if their baby is stolen. But stolen babies, they would, in a lot of cases, being sold on the black market instead of throwing them away here because all that's up as fresh as possible. There's a time frame, even the organs die as well. So there's a really a time frame within which they need to act to get those organs up so that it's as fresh as possible and still usable. Anyway, but the point of that is especially your abandoned babies and here there's no registration that has taken place. Those babies, what happened was between the hospital, the nurses, some of the nurses were part of the syndicate. Obviously, our obstetricians are involved, there's lawyers involved in everything. These babies were being sold on the black market. Various cases. Organ harvesting would be legal adoption. Illegal adoption is life. The tragic part of illegal adoption is that child may go into a home that may be a very well of home, families that can care of them. So, on the front, there's nothing wrong with that child's growing up in a good state of quiet. This child's getting the best of both worlds. But a crime is happening on that number one. That child finds out later on, I was stolen, black mark. That family, because you have these agents acting as if they are above board, but they are not. And they're taking the monies. So that family ends up being destroyed because they find out everything they've done was illegal. That child's life was destroyed. The mother, the father, let's say the child was taken and not just abandoned. There's the whole family destroyed. So something that here has now all along seemingly all good has now been tainted. It's tainted all along, but it's come to the fore once it all comes out and once these things are exposed. So about last year, we were involved in a rescue. A mother pretended she was pregnant still. And found out, and when I got to the scene, I realized something was really, really wrong with me. When I looked at them, so I went and I thought, okay, let me meet this girl. And my first fear was, if she's being kidnapped, taken, my worry was that they're taking her to take the baby for whatever reason. But when I got there, speaking to everybody, I realized here is something horribly wrong. The people I'm speaking to are actually involved. And I sat there and I thought, okay, Hillary, you've got to play along here and pretend. We got to a point where I said, okay, I'm going to get in my car and I'm going to cross. I'm going to pitch. I got all of our provincial commission of police. I actually got all the news of our country. He actually said, I said to him, something I said to someone, and we now immediately. You got the provincial police involved. I said, we need to get to Durban. This is what's happening. Turned out that yes, there was this person was not pregnant. This person had lost the baby. This person, and this is how they work. They'll prey on the vulnerability of that person that's not desperate for a baby. They prey on the vulnerability of the person that wants to give up a baby. The person wanting to give up the baby was a young girl, apparently from a family, affluent family, and didn't want them to know anything about what had happened. And this young girl was going to give birth. So they preyed on this. So while we were sitting there, we tapped into a big adoption ring out far out in Springs, we got various calls, and then the numbers are no longer existent, so we got the snippets of things that were happening that we could report on. Picked up our Facebook, things that were and trailed a whole thing on Facebook, fronting as the church organization to assist with adoption. Legal adoptions, and it wasn't the case. It was taking advantage of these individuals outside. Found out the mom had actually twice That is a time before we couldn't really ping. The pinging had stopped, especially the Killian case that took that pinging came to the end for all the private investigators. So your towers are your moralists. What this person did was they left their phone in case again, making us think they're still in the area and they want to go really on their way back to Johannesburg on the way. So this newborn baby got to Johannesburg eventually. We had some people that were eyes and ears who left there because we were now very suspicious of the people that were around us. Contacted us and said, the baby and the sponsor is here. So all the baby clothes, so everything that they prepared. Okay. We got arrested. That very night, and the baby was removed and placed the baby into a place of safety. Still named the baby after half of my name and another individual's name. Beautiful little baby. But those are the kind of things that spread within itself on our doorsteps. So that's just on that aspect. We have the aspect of our teenagers. Most of the human trafficking is picked up close to. Almost 50% of it is emanating off social media these days. Your greeting, your engagement, your grooming, everything. Your whole manipulation, your whole deception is taking place on social media before the actual meeting happens. So we have what you call stranger danger, quite rightly so. We do need to teach our children about stranger danger. But that stranger is human trafficking. The law of human trafficking is not a stranger. Most times it's somebody that's really close. It's somebody that is learning you, that has befriended you, that has earned your trust to the point that you think this person is the next best thing to slice bread. And what this person will be to you is the answer to your problem. The answer to that desperate situation, the answer to that vulnerable spot, the answer to that need or that want, especially our teenagers. I want this, but I can't have it, or my parents won't give it to me, or my parents can't afford it, and I want it. So I express that vulnerability out there. My parents do not give me the love, the attention, the care that I need. That need is expressed on social media. It becomes something that we call validation. Our young girls that are looking for validation in terms of compliments, in terms of male or romantic gestures on social media platforms, companionship. Those are tools that these guys or vices will zone into, traffickers will zone into, and they will need that tool. Jobs, children pay, marketing jobs, and getting into marketing, and reporting something in the media. So, Act Africa has many shelters under our wing, and we see to them in the world, it's especially women and children that have gone through lots of abuse, men and women, and those issues. So we work about that. So I have Luna speaking to one of our shelters, those are my ladies. They've gone through hell and high waters. So I've had a lot of sessions with them and that kind of thing. And some of them even now still. So I've worked very close with them, communication with them at a very high level, even once they left the home that they've been raised in for whatever reason that they've been taught in. And a lot of it is modeling contracts. And these guys come across, they use WhatsApp, they use humanity, and they see these pictures of these girls, and that is why I say, girls, again, you in the world of modeling, you come from the world of modeling. I don't know if you know Icon International. I work very closely with Sharon. Sharon is a good friend of mine. And just recently she reported something to me, and our provincial from Walks immediately acted on it. It was a notification on the job. All fake, all tracks for human trafficking. A lot of the modeling, so much of the modeling scans were on the promises of jobs. Look at all the men that were rescued now after the Zachariah Park just a month ago. Last year, December was the Mondial. Brought in, guess how those poor guys were brought in from Mondial? In tankers, petrol tankers, brought them to South Africa. So imagine with those fumes. So you already high on the fumes. So, years ago, we were involved in rescues, Point Road, Durban. So I worked with a lot of colleagues in Durban as well. We picked up and put them in the underground pipes and get them into the containers through rescue that we were involved in. And that's where we picked up also in the things of his life. El Dorado Park is alive with human trafficking. It is so right. And often we don't know that it is human trafficking. So, I want to just go into a little bit of what human trafficking is. It is what is done, which means it's the act, the recruitment, transportation, transfer, harboring of persons. Remember, it's not always kidnapping. People have a perception taken off the street and it's trafficking. Most times, that isn't that is because when you hear there's something that is business related or a child that's been kept away from somebody, so I will kidnap that child or things like that. Very small percentage of kidnapping is actually trafficking related. When it is trafficking related, it is kidnapping, so it's not going to fall. A lot of times it's your loved ones, which is then taken for organ harvesting. You get the rookies on the street that you organize use. And it's a syndicate, it's an organized crime. It's not like your normal domestic violence that you be at your FCS unit and alternate FCS unit will work along with your organized crime unit, and together they will then with your NPA, with your Department of Social Development, with immigration if needed, will work along to then determine, and obviously the nature of trafficking is trafficking, so that is why when it is reported, it's always reported as possible trafficking. Because it has to be determined according to what I'm going to tell you now. So the act is what is done, recruitment, transportation, transfer, harboring and receipt of persons. The means is how it is done. Force, coercion, deception, manipulation, fraud, all of those kind of things. Okay, so there's many abuse of power, use of somebody's desperate status, vulnerabilities, abuse of all of those things. There's also dead bondage. You owe somebody money, and because you owe that person that money, you are in a dead bondage. I was like this country in the Bible, oh no man, nothing except love. That dead bondage, that person takes advantage of it and says, you owe me money. And because of that, that's where number six, trafficking comes in, you will now pay off this debt, do this, 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 that. Even though it's the self-care, forced labor, all of those kind of things. Those are the kind of things. Then you get the purpose, why it is done. Quite obviously, exploit and then money. Human trafficking has surpassed drug trafficking, has surpassed arms trafficking. It used to be number three, it is now number one. Biggest $1 billion earner worldwide. I've just given you figures of the organs, how much organs cost. So that's our Wait a second. So imagine you in the medical faculty, you in anyone that's in the law fraternity, in the justice system, that owns it. Wait, I'm not saying that you earn a lot of money, but I mean, generally, your income is higher than your average person that would be working as a in the bank or wherever else. That kind of thing. Your career option is just putting you in that bracket. It exceeds that. It exceeds, I imagine, that's the number one income earner. That is scary. So what does that tell you? Follow the money. Follow slavery. So human trafficking happens in your lifestyle. So that is why it's so dangerous. That guy on the street that they often pick up is just a whore. That guy that's sitting up there, the new vision, is sitting in a massive house with lots of cars, businesses. He could even be that geek that's very well off. That politician that's sitting up there that you're looking at to say make a difference is very much involved in world. Lawyers, doctors, you name it. Course of getting it. Now Dana in the Bible was like a Bible. Biblical days, it speaks about slavery, was the first person ever to be in slavery. So people often say, slavery happened and in the Bible it was condoned, it was never condoned. What does it say? Jesus Christ came to set the captives free. And that is what we have to set God's hands free, his eyes and ears, and to set the captives free. Thank you. focus on the screen.